Can you spare a tiny moment, please, Erica?
What are you doing here?
Well, I wouldn't insist, but it's so important. Now, please don't think I'm being unduly critical, but was it necessary to ban all privileges? They long for TV, the poor things. They haven't anything else, you see.
Are you here as the prisoner's elected representative?
Well, yes, I suppose I am, really.
Then I suggest you go back and tell them that until they are willing to accept responsibility for one another's actions, they will have to suffer the consequences of those actions.
But isn't that being a tiny bit unfair? Wouldn't it be more positive for you to channel your efforts into finding the guilty party?
Are you telling me how to run this prison?
Oh, no, no, I'm just offering suggestions. I promised the girls I would, you see.
It appears to me you are undermining my authority.
Is hardline authority wise, Erica? Isn't it counterproductive? I mean, you know as well as I do that you can catch more flies with honey than with vinegar.
You will stop calling me Erica. You will address me as Governor or Mrs. Davidson. You will speak only when you are spoken to, and you will not have the impertinence to come to this office without an appointment.
Oh, dear.
My advice to you is to keep out of my way and not compound the damage you have already done.
Damage me?
You have abused privileges I have given you. You who should have set an example. Because of you, I have exposed my officers to ridicule and the department to humiliation. I lay yesterday's debacle wholly and solely at your door.
But it wasn't a debacle until the very end. We were all having a wonderful time, and they were all very enthusiastic about my halfway house project. I mean, you were yourself. You made a marvelous speech to the media.
Then I have changed my mind. I see no point in creating a home for women who have no more sense than a common vandal.
Oh, one poor demented creature externalizing her miseries.
Must I send for a warder, or will you leave this office of your own accord?
I understand, dear. It's a bad time of the month.